Commanders, and welcome back for another round at Jormag. We had a video earlier today where we showed three different builds, two of which were fantastic. But we have something even better, especially given the changes. We've discovered today that you can get an S+ chest just by achieving the number of hearts. You don't even have to out-damage anybody else. All you have to do is get the hearts. So we want to do that as inexpensively as possible. So here we have a community submission. Anturium strikes again. He has submitted another fantastic layout, and we're going to have a look at that right now. First, however, if you would please like, subscribe, and if you want notifications when I drop new videos, hit that notification bell. Also, if you have any comments, please leave them below. All right, let's get right after it. This is the build. No elixirs. We are running with Primal Warhorn, Ring of Unity, and Spear of Cataclysm. The Anturium ran it with the Pendant of Everlasting Winter, if I recall. But I figured, hey, why not throw it on there? If it hits him, that's another 600k damage. Not that it matters, because again, you just need the heart now. You don't even need to rack up the damage. So here we've got a bomb right up front, and that... and I'll just make a comment here. Every single one of my bombs has run 3 on it. I'm not sure if it matters what level of run speed you have. I just think you kind of need some run speed, and you want them all to be the same. In Anturium's video, if you watch it, he's got different run speeds on each of his bombs, and it kind of offsets them and kind of fans them out a bit, which could cause some problems, but he was still successful with it, so hey, no complaints there. I've put the same run speed on all of them, and they're just barely, all these ones in the back are just barely in front of that back line, and that's what's been working for me. But this one is right up front, and that's designed to catch this full group of shield bearers in the front. The middle and the bottom earth elementals are going to fan out towards the direwolves, and the plague bearers really aren't there for anything other than to buff the Primal Warhorn. So the Primal Warhorn, you get extra percentage towards damage for every body over 60, so the plague bearers buff that. Then if you look at the Ring of Unity, you get a 60% buff to your bombs for the first 6 seconds. And that's why you want those run speeds on there, to get there in time. But also, on the Primal Warhorn, I've got my first attunement set to the max at 45%. I really lucked out with that roll. So that's going to be fantastic for getting them to sail right through to the boss. So there's the basic setup. You can probably put, you'll notice Anturium puts his rear plague bearers up and forward and down and forward, and the assassins still go after him there just fine. So there's a little bit of leeway as to where you can place those. So let's go ahead and show you how we did. This was Anturium. So let's have a look at him. So this was his build. You'll notice he has lower unit levels, but he still gets the job done. And this is on SR11. So one rank down on the star ratings, but very effective, and he gets the job done. Nothing else really matters after that point, because you got the heart and you can move right along. So we bump over here, and you'll notice all 5 of these are successful attempts. Every single one of them. It's very smooth, it runs very well. We're probably not going to show every single one of them, but every single one of them was a success. So here goes. Oh, you'll notice he's got 1 heart left. So I knocked that out. Poof. We have slain the Jormag. But there it is. It's said and all said and done. And we'll just run another one just to show you. But it's just smooth as butter. Just sails right through. The earth elementals part, and they just cruise right in there. The earth elementals, they start to turn around and start to attack, and they just stand in place while the bombs run right by, so it's perfect timing. So depending on the buff that you get on your Primal Warhorn, if you want to roll to try and get that to a high speed, this is attempt number 3. I think I've done 6 altogether. I recorded 5 of them, and then I stopped recording because I'm like, okay, I think we get the point. But just very smooth, and every single time I'm getting about the same amount of damage. It's not fickle like the Arcane Reconstruction Hammer, where you might get procs and you might not. This is guaranteed damage, so long as all of your units get there. So here's attempt number 4 while I'm still yattering. But Yeah, very smooth. You notice the assassins in the back, they're all occupied. The bombs get there in plenty of time, and then boom, there's the spear at the end to polish them off. So if you're looking for a very solid build, it just works every time. There hasn't been any problems with it at all. Here's number 5. And again, I think I've done 6 altogether, and every single one of them has just sailed right through. There it is. Same 196,000 every single time. So now that it doesn't matter how much damage you do, so long as you get the heart, you don't need to spend the elixirs on this one. So there it is. Thank you for watching, and thank you to Anturium for submitting another fantastic build. There's a lot of bomb trains out there, but this one just seems to be running like clockwork. I just love it. So thank you for the submission. And again, if any of you guys have submissions you want to put in, we can show everybody and give you a shout out. So thanks for watching, and we'll have some more content for you in the coming days.